Na, herrlich.
Seven Hells. Play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat? Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There. Hear that? I know I heard something. Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
Ich dachte schon, ich bin am Arsch. Oh mein Gott, nein. Der hat doch jetzt nicht die komplette Front abgeschnitten, oder? Oh mein Gott.
Bloody hell.
Lord Ethan! As I was saying, you are young, and there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forester Lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise and courageous in battle.
And what will they call me?
That is for you to define as the new lord. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others. The Lord Sentinel. Forester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move!
Summon the Lord! We need his judgment.
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Why did you kick this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
You stole from us?
I feared for my life. Yes, my lord. I fled.
We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks truth. Right.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here.
Where's our pay?
Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy, go.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
The men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their Lord will not permit it.
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us.
You must deserve to live.
Make him pay for what he stole. Give us justice.
Fuck him.
I will decide.
Send him to the war.
Leave the poor man.
Take his fingers.
He's a thief.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
Oh mein Gott. Gnade? Dann nehmen sie mich nicht für voll. Drei Finger ab ist zu hart. Zur Mauer schicken?
I sentence you to the wall, where you will join the Night's Watch.
Oh, please, my lord! My family, without me they'll die!
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course. It can weigh on any lord.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
The wall seems like a fitting place for a thief. I only hope he doesn't find Garrett there and take his anger out on the poor squire. You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here. The bracer of the sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choice as sentinel.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Phew.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, Who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
That's a clever strategy.
I do hope that's a good thing, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow, at first light.
Uncle, why are you packing? You're not going somewhere, are you?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course. Until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. Of course I'll be gentle.
I know you will. You're good-hearted, my lord. That is your true strength.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice. And I'd trust him.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Is that anstrengend?
Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. You promised me you wouldn't change, and I believed you.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrett being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
Well, I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please. Tell me.
What do you suggest I do?
You must be strong. Decisive. You are the Lord of this house. Remember, you're just as capable as Asher or Roderick ever were. I know it. I only wish you did too.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
Ich würde gerne noch mal mit ihr sprechen. Ich wusste, ich kann das nicht noch mal.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carve this to give me strength. And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, oh, you know, don't you?
I'm honored.
Someday, I'll have have a real one, but not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword, I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them. Enemies.
No, he's not our enemy, but he did a bad thing.
Then I wish you'd hurt him. People who do bad things need to be punished. Someone did something bad to Father and Roderick. Someone should hurt them even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
Slash and parry! Slash and parry! Again! Sword up! Swing left! Parry! Wrong! I didn't know
Sir
dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. What's the state of our defences? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny, and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and centre. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roiland. I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come.
Come on, you dogs! You'll not be fighting here forever!
Yes, my lord.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrod to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud. Seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
I haven't made my decision yet, but I appreciate your opinion.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
Oh mein Gott. Ich kann nicht. Ich kann mich nicht entscheiden. Es ist natürlich wichtig.
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
Ransom or a robbery? We may pay him now, but what's to stop him from coming back again?
Lord Ethan, the dangers of today outweigh the fears of tomorrow.
Leute, ich kann mich nicht entscheiden. Ich sage immer so, der am ehesten, es gibt da so eine Regel, so ein Sprichwort, glaube ich, der danach fragt.
Are you holding a sword or a turkey leg?
Jetzt redet er dazwischen. Der danach fragt, einer, der nicht darauf besteht, ist meistens mehr wert als der es sozusagen einfordert. Der eine Typ ist auch arrogant und fordert es ein. Der andere sagt, okay, weise Worte, blablabla, ihr werdet schon wissen, wen ihr wählen müsst. Er hat nicht darauf bestanden, das fand ich sehr sympathisch. Jetzt weiß ich bloß nicht, ob das das Richtige ist. Ich gehe noch ein bisschen spazieren. Ich kann aber keinen mehr sprechen. Ich bin halt bloß... Irgendwann muss er die Truppen vorbereiten. Er ist ja trotzdem noch da. Er ist bloß nicht der Hüter. Aber ich habe nicht das Gefühl, dass ich dem vertrauen kann. Ich finde, dem Onkel kann ich mehr vertrauen. Aber ich kann ja erstmal in den Turm gehen. Vielleicht kriege ich da jetzt noch ein paar Eindrücke. Ist die Mutter da? Oben irgendwo? Irgendwer, mit dem ich hier sprechen kann?
Swords up! You can lift them, yeah?
Ich werde mich für den Onkel da entscheiden. Tut mir leid, Leute. In die Kommentare, warum ihr was anderes gewählt hättet. Oder warum ihr meiner Meinung seid. Das wäre echt wichtig.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel. But I have made my decision.
Oh mein Gott, Leute.
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle? This is reckless. Lord Ethan has made his choice. I will not disappoint you, my lord.
Now, Sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here, with no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword. That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls. Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the bloody small council.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not. We need to take a cunning approach. Diplomacy can be a sharper instrument than a sword.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
We all must agree on the plan. We cannot leave until we have a consensus.
Ugh.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough! My new sentinel favors a certain approach, and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance, and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, You're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong?
That's enough, Roiland. Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall, and we will not offer our ironwood.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, I have fought for this family for many years. Do not forget that.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
Yes, I hear what you're saying.
Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth.
Who?
Of course, your father was furious. But you were in danger, and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities. But you do not have that anger inside you.
I'm not like that, but I don't need to be, do I?
No, but you need someone who is standing beside you. I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Leute, das sind schwere Entscheidungen, die man hier treffen muss. Alter Schwede. Heiliges Blechle. Habe ich schon Heiliges Blechle gesagt? Gott. Das ist... Warum habe ich jetzt den Schlüssel genommen?
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you'd want to know.
Thank you.
Mira, look.
It's a cloud?
The other day when you asked Lady Marjorie for help, I only spoke out of fear for her. I want to help you if there's anything I can do. Your poor family. I can't imagine how you must feel.
You're sweet to offer, Sarah. Thank you.
Lady Marjorie is always saying how important friends and allies are in King's Landing. Just know, I will be here for you if you ever...
Oh.
My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
Are you all right, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when I left him.
But my family, they're still in danger.
Your family isn't the only thing in jeopardy, Mira.
My little brother is only 7 years old. I'm afraid for him, for all of them. Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath.
Jetzt weiß ich auch, wozu ich das Siegel aufgenommen habe. Ich werde einen Brief bestimmt fälschen.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen, and maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, now we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family. If you'll excuse me, my lady.
Milady. Begging your pardon, milady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
I'm glad to see you.
Thank you, milady. I hope you saw. I was right before. About Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, milady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I can be useful to you.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who... People who'd be willing to help you.
Er.
Where's Sir Roiland? He should be here. The man values pride more than honor. We'll do without him. And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men stand ready to act if needed.
I hope so.
You made the right decision, my lord.
Isn't this a lovely pile of timber? Not the place I'd want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House Bolton? Son of Roose Bolton. Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority of the
Warden
of the...
Thank you, Lord. That's enough. Who is this little boy? Is he lost?
May I offer you bread and salt, Lord Ramsay?
I loathe bread and salt. Aren't you the little lord? Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this... Look at you.
Ich kann den Typen aus der Serie schon nicht leiden. Ich würde ihm am liebsten ein Messer in den Kopf stecken.
The new warden of the north.
Let me guess. Forrester Ironwood.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much. Don't know what's so special about it.
Your father will appreciate it, I hope. Our ironwood is highly sought after.
My father is not so easily impressed. Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn...
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
We really must focus on the business at hand.
What is it you want, Lord Ramsay?
What do I want? Everything. Nothing. We'll see. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the King. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
We will double our efforts for your father, my lord.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester. They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton. Yet your man lived.
Lord Whitehill is a liar. That's not how it happened.
Lad? A liar? He's a Whitehill. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The ironwood? But...
That is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another fucking job.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them. You cut them down.
We have loyal craftsmen who make the finest weapons. The Whitehills have no such craftsmen. Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point. We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the King's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me. You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
You have no right.
White Hills have no place here, lads.
Do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Duncan, don't.
Look at this, little forester. You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother. I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
We have more to discuss, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well. I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the bold lord?
Ethan! No!
What have you done?
No!
But I don't want a bold lord. Far too much trouble.
Ethan! Ethan! No!
Bastard!
No!
Even though you did bend the knee.
My son,
I think we've come to an understanding.
Lord Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
What have you done?
However, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Brian!
Lovely meeting all of you.
We'll have to do it again sometime.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the maester quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mother!
Stop!
Don't
let him go!
Let
him go! Stop
them!
Help me! Ryan,
please!
Let me go!
Ryan!
Do something! Ethan?
Oh, my son. Oh, my God. Oh, Vaz.
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties. Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?